researchers failed to label it as painful. So according to Jeff Poggio and B.B. Mountcastle, two scientists, they say that most researchers usually label such stimuli as tissue destructive, escape provoking, and emotion changing, but rarely ever call them painful, even though they provoke a defense or escape maneuver accompanied by signs of an appropriate emotional change in the normal working animal and thus painful sensations when applied to man. Also, I would like to bring up the point that they said that there's not a lot of unnecessary animal research, but I would like to point out that our current laws insist on a lot of animal research that could easily be replaced by alternative methods. According to George Honka, it's illegal for health products with medical formulations to be accepted by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration without tests on animals. So that's the very preliminary test always involve animals, which means a lot of animals are being used. Also, according to George Honka, the embryo's tissues can replace animal testing, especially when we are investigating new drugs and asking questions about basic science. Also, they brought up the claim that animal research is necessary for breakthrough, but according to Dr. Sabine, developer of the polio vaccine, he stated that the cancer research bodies cause pain and suffering to hundreds of thousands of animals every year by inducing in animals by chemical or by radiation, large cancerous growth in their bodies and in their limbs. Giving cancer to laboratory animals has not and will not help us to understand the disease or to treat those persons suffering from it. Thus, there are too many differences between animals and humans to probably find a cure for cancer. According to Dr. Dallas Pratt, it is better to look for prevention than for cures of cancer. And to do this, we can look at the epidemiology of people without looking at animals. And this will in turn help many more people prevent cancer, because we have been looking for a cure for a long time and yet we have not found it. And also, I would like to bring up the fact, I would like to refute their claim that the AWA does cover rats and mice and birds. According to the 2002 Farm Security and Rural Investment Act, the rats, mice, and birds are not covered if they are bred for use of research, which is the majority of animals used in research. Also, I'd like to point out that many laws for stolen pets entered the research animal trade despite the AWA. According to former Congressman George B. Brown Jr., the Animal Welfare Act does not have great success in preventing lost or stolen pets from entering the research animal trade. And I would like to refute their claim that the APHIS is effective at enforcing the AWA. Also, according to George E. Brown Jr., he states that the APHIS has been neglecting its statutory obligations and has renewed facility licenses even when cited violations past and present have not yet been corrected. So you can see that the AWA is not correctly enforced and it leads to many animals being involved in the trade or not being properly handled when they are researched on.